If you're flying in a helicopter, you want to make sure your pilot is focused on the controls. But with new technology, that pilot might not exist. Sikorsky demonstrated autonomous flying in the UH-60 Black Hawk helicopter at Yuma, Arizona Proving Ground in October, using the Matrix Autonomy System. What kinds of missions would an autonomous utility helicopter fly? The dull, dirty, and dangerous jobs, mainly. In this case, Sikorsky and DARPA tested a resupply mission and a casualty evacuation. And while similar tests have maintained a pilot as a backup, this flight was 100% human-free. Sikorsky says its technology can fly 80 miles. Its mission was as low as 200 feet and hit about 115 miles an hour, and even used terrain to mask its signature. The company also tested external cargo missions, carrying 2,600 pounds on a 40-foot sling. Australia will buy 24 C-130s from the United States. The State Department cleared more than $6 billion in possible foreign military sales to Australia, which will allow it to purchase 24 Lockheed Martin-made C-130J-30 Super Hercules. The Pentagon's Defense Security Cooperation Agreement includes missile warning systems, infrared countermeasures, and other equipment and technology for the aircraft. The Royal Australian Air Force plans to use the aircraft to replace its aging cargo fleet and improve the service's capabilities. The Pentagon said in a statement that the fleet will not alter the balance of military power in the Indo-Pacific region. The sale comes as tensions increased recently between China and Australia, which is a key U.S. ally in the region. Media reports revealed that the U.S. Air Force plans to build dedicated B-52 bomber facilities at an airbase in northern Australia, a move that has irked Beijing. During a press conference with reporters, a Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesperson said that the move of U.S. long-range bombers to Australia may, quote, trigger an arms race in the region. Australian officials downplayed the movement of the U.S. nuclear-capable bombers on the continent, saying that rotating the planes there has been a common practice since the 1980s. The State Department has cleared Finland to buy 150 Lockheed Martin-made guided multiple launch rocket systems and related equipment for $635 million. Logistical considerations are included in the package. In addition to supplying weapons to Ukraine to fight Russia's continued invasion, the United States is also supplying NATO countries in Europe with weaponry to beef up its eastern flank. In the arms sales announcement, the State Department said the GMLRS will better equip Helsinki's air and land defense capability by increasing the Finnish national stockpile. Finland is not yet a NATO country. It applied to join in May, and 28 of the 30 member countries have approved its bid. Hungary and Turkey remain holdouts.